Hey beautiful people, how is everybody doing? Welcome back to my YouTube channel, I'm Dan, and today I'm gonna review for you guys one of the cheapest sunscreen I've ever found actually. But before I start, please consider following me on Instagram, on Facebook, subscribe to this channel for more videos like this, and also you can check me out on my Patreon where I post exclusive content, not related to skincare though, I post covers in there. And yeah, I just wanted to let you know guys that my face looks this bad because I did a chemical peel yesterday. It was a 20% salicylic acid peel, and that's why it doesn't look that great. I filmed the entire process. I did it by myself at home, and I'm gonna link it down below if you want to check it out. But yeah, this one is the wait, let me check. I actually have no idea how to pronounce this one. Gigot, that's the name. Oh, okay, wait, focus. Yeah, that's the name. It is Gigot. I have no idea how to pronounce this one. It is their whitening UV sunblock. Looks like this, and this is definitely, in my experience, the cheapest sunscreen. This one is $7, $7, $8. I found it for $7 on YesStyle. And it has 70 mils, which is how many fluid ounces? There's actually no fluid ounces on the package, it's just 70 mils. And I think 60 mils, that's like two fluid ounces, so you do the math. Okay, I'm gonna start with the packaging, which looks pretty nice. It looks pretty expensive, I would say. It looks pretty fancy. Definitely not a $7 sunscreen package. Come on, boy. Yeah. Much better. Okay, looks pretty nice, pretty convenient, I would say. You just open it. I'm gonna show you the texture, which is really nice. I mean, for a $7 sunscreen, it has a beautiful texture. It spreads, oh come on, it spreads pretty easily. I think I actually, okay, yeah, it has a fragrance. I'm gonna talk about the fragrance in just a little bit, but it spreads pretty easily. It leaves kind of like not a matte finish, a semi-matte maybe. It is definitely not dewy. It is pretty, it's pretty matte. It may be a little bit shiny, just a little bit, just in the beginning. It's gonna disappear in a couple of minutes. It feels pretty hydrating. A little bit, it is not sticky though. Yeah, beautiful texture. Finish-wise, I would actually say this is more matte than the Claire's, but it's not as matte as the Comfy Water by Purito, which is my favorite sunscreen. But it's definitely more matte than this one, actually. Price, like I said, is around $8. I bought it for $7 on YesStyle. But it has fragrance, though. It has fragrance, so if you are trying to avoid fragrances, if you have sensitive skin, I would not recommend this one. The fragrance, it is not very powerful. It is very pleasant. It doesn't dissipate right away. It's gonna take a little bit of time for it to dissipate, but it's not gonna dissipate completely. Sometimes I can actually smell it at the end of the day, so it's not gonna dissipate completely, but the fragrance is just so good. It smells like an expensive perfume or something like that. It's really nice. It is not, it doesn't smell like essential oils or flowers or fruits. It just smells really, really good. And I'm pretty sure many of you guys are gonna like the fragrance, but I don't really recommend, putting fragrance on your skin on this channel. However, this is a sunscreen. It's not gonna penetrate your skin. And if all the other products that you use are fragrance-free, you can spoil yourself. Okay, when it comes to sun protection, this one offers SPF 50 plus, PA plus, plus, plus. And that's another downside, I would say. It only has 3 pluses, which is, it is a pretty good UVA protection, but it's not the best. 4 pluses is the best. That's gonna be around 12 PPD protection, UVA protection. So I would only recommend using this if you are inside, if you're not gonna go outside, if you're not gonna be outside for a long time, definitely. It is a combination sunscreen when it comes to the filters. This one has titanium dioxide as its mineral filter. And it also has, let me check, octinoxate as the organic or chemical filter. That's basically why this one has 3+, because it doesn't have zinc oxide, it only has titanium dioxide. And by the way, when it comes to the, I forgot to mention the white cast, invisible. I don't see any white cast on my skin. Maybe if you are, you have more darker skin, you're gonna notice. Okay, and ingredient wise, first ingredient is water, which is very normal. We have hydrolyzed collagen as the second ingredient, and I think many people are gonna be attracted by this one, but collagen in a product, in a skincare product, it's not gonna give you more collagen to the skin. It's only gonna be hydrating and moisturizing, because collagen cannot, the molecule of collagen, it's too big to actually penetrate your skin. So yeah, there's an emollient, there's butylene glycol, which is a great humectant, there's beeswax, and I don't know that many things about beeswax. I think it's kind of like same as the propolis. It has some antioxidants, it's gonna be soothing for the skin, it's gonna offer some moisturization or hydration, I don't know. There's also vitamin E in this one, titanium dioxide, which is the mineral filter. What else? Fragrance is actually pretty high on the ingredient list. It's actually kind of like in the middle, and usually it is at the end of the ingredient list. That's why I'm kind of like, there's a lot of fragrance in this one. We also have dimethicone, which is a silicone, and there are some people that don't want silicones in their products, so you have to be aware of that. Adenosine, good anti-aging ingredient, aloe extract, hydrating, glycerin. We have arbutin. That's why I guess this one is called whitening sunblock, because it has arbutin. It is pretty low on the ingredient list. I would say there's definitely less than 1%, so it's not gonna be that effective, but still it is in there, so it may offer a little bit of whitening, but I guess that little bit may be because of the titanium dioxide. Overall, for $7, that's a pretty impressive ingredient list, I would say. It has some beneficial ingredients. So yeah, if you are on a really low budget and you don't mind fragrances, this is gonna be a great one for you. The texture is really nice. SPF 50+, PA 3+ is only. That's kind of like a downside for me, but for many people it's not gonna be a downside. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed my review for the Gigot Whitening UV Sunblock. They also have the exact same product, but with snail extract instead of the whitening one, I guess instead of arbutin, they have put on. they put snail extract in the sunscreen. And this is a sunscreen that doesn't really have many reviews online, because I was trying to find some reviews to see what other people think of it, and there are not that many actually. Yeah, that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you find it helpful. If you did so, give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think about the sunscreen. Are you gonna try it or not? And what other products I should check. Love you all. See you on my next video. Bye.